the door. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war. We can't be defeated, let them know from the door. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war. Before you go to battle, you should know what you're up against. When Yah sends his army on a mission, it ain't no defense. Have the latest weapons up, go and learn Kung Fu, or you can read the Art of War written by Sun Tzu. You gon' need all of the above when we come through. When Yah sends the order out, where you gon' run?
Keep my commandments.
Say what?
If ye love me, keep my commandments.
That's the whole thing of this Bible. Keep the commandments. Matter of fact, give me Deuteronomy 22:5. Because I just want to show y'all a few. And like I said, we're not going to try to attack y'all, sister. That's not what we're out here to do, brothers. We're not out here to attack you. We're just here to correct. The Most High set up us to be his high priest. And he gave us the knowledge to understand this Bible. Not according to the pastors, but according to us. So give me that Deuteronomy 22:5 right quick.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22, verse 5.
Bring it out.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Okay, sister, now like I said, we're not to attack you, but what clothes, article of clothes do you have on that pertains to a man? Pants, tights or pants. Because guess what? Like my brother always say, if you go to the bathroom and you look and you can't, it don't got women's or men's, rather we just got a picture.
Yes.
How do you know what bathroom to go into? Because the woman has on a what? Our prayer, sister, the woman has on a dress. Alright, man, I need y'all to come back, man. You gonna say, give me Deuteronomy 7:6 right quick to show y'all who y'all are, man. Before y'all go, man, we need y'all to understand this, man. That it gonna be a plenty of trains come. Plenty of trains gonna come, and that's exactly what's right. Y'all supposed to be getting this. Because y'all are the leaders of the household. So when you can give it to your old ladies. Y'all can give her this history and this knowledge. But it's really for y'all to get it to give. You understand? Bring that out.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
So the word holy in the Bible means separate. We separated from all these other nations, but we something totally different. That's why LeBron James is the greatest on the planet, one of the greatest basketball players. That's why these so-called whites and these so-called other nations can't compare to what we do. It don't matter, we get in the hockey. We go still prevail in the hockey game. Now you say you got a so-called black brother on the front of the hockey page right now. You know what I'm saying? Because we are the greatest appearing people. So read it.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Uh-huh.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
No, not above all people.
That are above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Brother, you know you're the greatest thing on this planet according to the Bible? You got time to talk to him? We already trying to tell you how great you are, man. Deuteronomy 7:6 said, for thou art a holy people, you separate. Our people got to understand, man, that this is serious. It's going to be plenty of trains coming, man. It's going to be plenty of time, but it ain't. You don't know how much time you got before the Lord cracked that sky.
That's right.
But it's going to be plenty of trains going back and forth. But Deuteronomy 7:6, bring it out one more time. That's who you are.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 6.
Read.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Possession. You are separate unto the Lord himself. He chose you. You so-called blacks, you so-called Latinos and Native Americans, the Most High chose you to be a special people.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
Possession unto himself. You doing all right, bro? You got 20 minutes to give us some time, man? We out here for you, man. We're trying to tell you how great you are, brother.
Unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
So we have a chance to be above all people that are upon the face of the earth. But there's certain things we gotta do. We have to keep the laws. We have to keep the statutes and commandments of the Most High. Let's jump into Deuteronomy, man, and get some of these and get exactly what's going on. Give me 28:1. We're gonna show you blessings and curses, because that's all this Bible is set up to do. It's set up to, if you obey the laws, you get blessings. If you do not want to obey the laws and keep walking around calling yourself Negroes and niggers and ways and what's so about those and all this, then you will not get the blessings. Y'all doing all right? They don't even care. Our people don't even care, man. Bring that out.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Now he said, it shall come to pass if we will hearken, listen diligently. We're not them same people, brother. You need to get that, man. You need to get that, brother. You need to holler at us too, man. I'm telling you.
I got you.
I'm not going to make you do nothing, brother.
Oh, I got you.
But you really need to do this for yourself, man. Because we're trying to get to the kingdom, man.
I know,
now bring that out again. That's Deuteronomy 28 and 1. We're trying to show you that if you would do what he said do, that we would get blessed, brother.
And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So that means if we will listen, he said it's going to come to pass, that means it's going to happen. Every time this Bible states it's come to pass, it has came to pass. Bible prophecy is the greatest over everything, because it always rules over everything. It's always undefeated. So if you will hearken, and not just listen, but listen diligently. You know what that word diligently mean? With a strong aggression, man, like with all your might, hard, very aggressive. That's what we gotta be. We gotta be aggressive with this Bible. We gotta listen, man. You doing all right, brother? You got 5 minutes of your time to talk to us? Come give us some time, brother. We don't need all your time, just a few minutes. Don't go nowhere, brother. We need you, man. We need you to get this understanding, man.
To observe and to do all his commandments.
So we have to do all the commandments, brother. Not some. How many commandments are there in the Bible? 10? That's what you've been taught, right? That's what we out here to do. Break down the lies, brother. It's over 613 commandments.
That's
laws,
right.
Laws are commandments. Statutes are commandments. You understand that? Commandments are commandments. So I'm going to give you a commandment right now, brother. Leviticus, give me the ball here. Because you know that's an Egyptian custom. But I know you got your hair kind of growing on the side, but do you shave it?
I have to.
You have to shave it? Not according to the Bible. You both, just look. You remember Weezy and George Jefferson? You see George Jefferson, they cut that off. He kept that George. That's what we call a hairstyle, George Jefferson, right? You got a George Jefferson, you better keep a George Jefferson. Let me show you why.
The book of Leviticus chapter 21 and verse 5.
Bring it out.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
Now this is a law too, brother. We should not make baldness upon our head. That's not our custom. That was the Egyptian custom. We not Michael Jordan. When Michael Jordan did that, he wasn't doing that right. He supposed to keep that hair off there too.
Neither shall they shave off the corner of their head.
And like you,
beard.
Of their beard, like he was saying. You supposed to let your beard grow too. Don't shave it at all. And just let it grow. That's your manhood. That's your dignity as a man.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
And we shouldn't get no tattoos either. And I know a lot of people say, man, y'all got tattoos. I can see your tattoos. Yeah, but we repented for our tattoos, and we're not going back into that anymore.
That's right.
You know, we had tattoos before we got into this truth. I know y'all doing, I hope y'all doing all over there, brother.
You got some princesses with you, man. You got princesses over there, man. That's what the Bible calls them little sisters, man. Princesses. You got that king in your hand. But do they call us that? Do they call us that? They call us everything but that. Give me Deuteronomy 32:39. They don't call us that. They don't give us our great name, who we are, because they don't want you to know it.
They want you to be a Negro, a nigger. A porch monkey, a cook, they want you to be all that. But the Bible says that you are the greatest thing on this planet, man. You think they're going to tell you the truth? This is their land. They're not going to tell you the truth of who you are. But we out here to break down them lies, man. Bring that out.
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16.
Bring it out.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
That you are the temple. That brother was over here smoking a cigarette, man. Anything that you do to defile your temple, man, can be anything that the Lord said not to do, man. You got to be sober, clean, righteous to keep going.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
So the Spirit is inside of you. It's in you to do right. But you know, we always want to do wrong, man. We always want to do what we see everybody else doing, what the other nations are told us to do. The white woman said she want to wear pants. Now all our sisters are wearing pants. And not only are they wearing pants, they're wearing drawers and tights out here in public. You are not supposed to do it. You are the temple of God.
If any man defiles the temple.
If any woman defiles the temple. Defiling the temple can go into smoking. Defiling the temple can be going into other religions. Doing all these other doctrines. Practicing holidays. Holidays. Doing Christmas. Doing Thanksgiving. These are not the days that we're supposed to celebrate. We have the Passover in the Bible. We have Feast of Tabernacle. And not only, these ain't one days. These are whole weeks. God. It's cursed to be in the Hebrew. We get whole weeks of our celebrations.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? But y'all want to keep doing this Thanksgiving with the number of slaughtering our Native American people.
Y'all know that too. We don't, it's not a rocket scientist to know that they slaughtered our people. On Thanksgiving, we gave still. We want to go to Big Mama house. Eat that pork. Eat them chillings. Eat them pig feet, them hog mouths. You are the temple of God. The family of temple can be more than just smoking. It can be taking on the customs of the other nations. Doing everything that you're not supposed to do. Because the Bible gave us strict guidelines to follow in this book. We have to do the book and do what the book tells us to do. And not what we want to do.
Keep reading it out.
If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
Nah, I'm not gonna get destroyed just for smoking a cigarette, man.
Him shall God destroy.
I'm just doing Christmas for the children.
Him shall God destroy.
Man, Big Mama turkey and dressing be bussing. I can't miss that turkey and dressing.
Him shall God destroy.
Him shall God destroy. Ain't that what we getting done today? Ain't we getting destroyed as a nation of people? Ain't our black brothers and sisters out here losing their lives and stuff in these streets for nothing? It's because we disobeying the Most High. You doing all right, brother? You got time for us? You got 2 or 3 minutes to give us? Everybody got to go somewhere, man. I hope you get to go to heaven, man, to the kingdom. We need y'all, man. We need more people to stand up. Who's going to stand up for our Lord, man? Who's going to show possession to our Lord like he showed possession to us? We have to do this Bible, man, and do it diligently, man. We have to keep these laws, brothers. What you got for me?
32 and 39.
Yeah, because they call us everything, man. Like I said, their brother had some little children. He had some girls and some boys. The women are princesses, not queens. You're not no queens. Brothers, you are kings, according to the Bible. But they call us every other thing than that, man. Bring it up.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32 and verse 39. See now that I am he, and there is no God with me.
Now, that wasn't the scripture I wanted, but I'm definitely getting to that. Because we give the devil, you know what I mean, brother? You know who you are according to the Bible?
Yeah, I know.
Give us five and who are you, brother? Let me talk to you for a minute. Tell me who you are. Now, Deuteronomy 32 and 39 is letting you know that the Lord is God by himself. That he don't need no help. When he created this world, he created it by himself. He didn't need any help. So we giving everybody these accolades of what they doing. Just like we give a so-called white man too much power. He's only doing what the Most High set him up to do. They are only killing our black brothers because the Most High gave them the okay to do it.
That's right.
If the Most High didn't give them the okay, then that gun would to jail. Or something else would happen to where he wouldn't be able to do it. So bring this scripture out again.
The book of Deuteronomy. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32 and verse 39. See now that I am he, and there is no God with me.
Lord said he don't need no help being God. That's one thing he definitely don't need no help doing. It's being who he is, the Most High. That's why he is the Most High.
I kill.
The Most High don't kill.
I kill.
No, God is our love. It's love. He made everybody.
I kill, and I make alive.
Yeah.
I wound, and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand.
So the Most High said, if he wants you gone, you're going to be gone. Matter of fact, let's go to Deuteronomy 28 and 6 days. Press that. Because he said that can't nobody deliver you out of this situation unless he wants you out of this situation. So let's take it out and see and what he said about that, because do y'all know how we got over into America? I know some of y'all do, but we got to ask the question because a lot of people don't even know. We got over on them slave ships, man, our ancestors, and it's in the Bible. The scripture to go to find out how we got to America, to this wicked country, Babylon, is Deuteronomy 28 and 68. Bring it out.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Again. We've been into 7 captivities. Has the so-called white man been in 7 captivities? Has the so-called Moab Chinese been in 7 captivities? We've been captured by all these other nations. I wonder why. That's because we are the greatest on the planet.
That's right.
He said, I will bring you into Egypt again. Egypt has a meaning. Give me Exodus 20 and 2.
Bring it out, huh?
Give me Isaiah 28 and 9 and 10. Egypt has a meaning. And you know, as how we keep flipping back and forth in this Bible, it's because that is the proper way to read the Bible.
That's right.
Now, you can read the Bible into its entirety, but to get the understanding, you have to go scripture to scripture. I want Exodus 22. You have to go back and forth and get precept upon precept. We're going to get that. But Egypt has a meaning. Egypt means something. Let's see what it means.
This is Exodus chapter 20, verse 2.
Read.
I am the Lord thy God.
I am the Lord who?
Thy God.
Nah, everybody got.
Thy God.
I don't know why y'all miss these words. The Lord is showing strictly possession of who he is the God of.
That's right.
We see Israel in this Bible over 2,000 times. He let us know I am the Lord thy God, your God,
which I brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Now the Lord said he brought us out of the land of Egypt. Let's see what Egypt means in the Bible.
Out of the house of bondage.
Out of the house of bondage. So if you got somebody bonded or in bondage, that means you have them in slavery.
Bring it out.
So we're going to use Egypt and replace it with the word slavery. Let's go back to Deuteronomy 28 and 16. Did you know that, brother? You know how we got here on to America? Give me 5 minutes of your time. That's it, 5 minutes, bro. I know you got something to do, man. You can give us 5 minutes of your time. I'm out here for you.
See, I got to care. Go ahead. What's
up? I know it, bro. You better catch these laws. You better catch these commandments, because them buses going to be here. We don't know when my whole life going to crack this guy, though, right? So bring this out again, because I was just bringing out a scripture to let you know how to identify right. That we are the true Jews of the Bible. He said that he would bring us over here in a certain way. How do we get to America?
Hold on.
On a boat. Let's see if that's in the Bible. Bring it out. Read it again.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Egypt. Now, we just went to Exodus 20 and 2. We're not going to go back, but Exodus 20 and 2 says that Egypt has a special meaning. Egypt has is compared to bondage because we went into it came out of Egypt, you know, when the Most High parted the Red Sea. Egypt means bondage, so slavery. So let's replace Egypt with slavery in that term. Let's see what we got.
And the Lord shall bring thee into slavery again.
Again. We went into 7 captivities, brother. Every other nation, all these other nations that put us in captivities, man. Why? Why? Why they wanted to captive us? Because we the greatest. Because we built this kingdom. Because who going to pick that cotton like LeBron James and Michael Jordan? Who going to pick that cotton like Harriet Tubman and Marcus Garvey? We are the coldest people. So what they said again, and the Lord shall bring thee
into slavery again with ships.
So we went into 7 captivities. This the last one though. That's why we tell y'all it's time to get right, brother. Keep reading.
By the way thereof, I spake unto thee.
Well, he said it to us. We wasn't in America yet. We was over in Israel, right?
Thou shalt see it no more again.
So we wasn't gonna see our homeland again. Where we from? Give me that out. Where we from? Where everybody tell you we from?
Africa.
Everybody say we from Africa, right? We are not Africans, brother. Matter of fact, we got this underman Bible, but I'm going to give you a little history too, man. But let's get that right quick, because we are not from Africa. Let's see where we're from.
The book of Galatians, chapter 4, verse 26.
Bring it out.
But Jerusalem, which is above, is free.
But who?
But Jerusalem, which is above, is free.
Nah, Africa.
But Jerusalem, which is above, is free.
It's going to tell you the truth. Keep reading.
Which is the mother of us all.
Nah, we're from Africa, man.
Which is the mother of us all.
Didn't it say but Africa or didn't it say Jerusalem?
But Jerusalem, which is above, is free. Which is the mother of us all.
You know what that above and free mean? That Jerusalem is right above Africa. You understand that? We fled out of Israel and Jerusalem into Africa. When we went into slavery, man, when the Africans sold us to the white man. That's what the Africans did to us. So don't ever go around again telling you from Africa or you're African. Because you're not. Because they got judgment in this book too. You understand that? So let's keep reading this and finish this out, and I'm going to show you exactly what Ham means. Because that company is really named Ham. You know what I mean, young brother? Come on over and give me a few times, man. Give me a few minutes, bro. When I listen to you, I thank you for listening. Just check this out, brother, because this is serious, man. Yeah, from the top.
This is Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68.
Because how did we get here, brother? To America. How did our ancestors get here?
Ship.
Oh, ship, right. Let's see if it's in the Bible.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
Into slavery again. Egypt means slavery with ships.
By the way, Lord, I spake unto thee.
Well, he told us this was going to happen at.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
We weren't going to see our homeland, which is Israel, brother. We're Jerusalem.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
You hear that, young brother? When we get to America, we're going to be sold into our enemies. Who we got sold to? Now, who are they? That's the so-called white man. Don't be afraid to say it. And there, when you get to America, you're going to be sold into your enemies. For what?
For bond men.
For slave men.
And bond women.
And bond women and slave women. And what else?
And no man shall buy you.
And no man is going to get us out of this situation. Malcolm X couldn't do it. They killed Martin Luther King for that same reason. Martin Luther King said that we can be equal. You know what I mean, sister? Give us a little time. We just need a few minutes of your time.
I don't really have
it. Oh, sister, you ain't got time? I hope the Most High don't crack that sky today. Because we all don't got time for the Most High. We got time to go party. We got time to go to 7-Eleven. We got time to go get on this train and go see our sweetheart, or so we say. But we don't nobody got time for this Bible. It doesn't make sense to me, man. You have to give the Lord just as much time as he give us. He give you time on this earth every day. You need to give him time in that Bible every day. So let's finish that one more time. I want them to hear that one more time, how we got over here. Because a lot of people don't know. Deuteronomy 28 and 68 lets us know how we got to America.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again
with the slavery again
with ships.
With what?
With ships.
Now, as we walked over here.
With ships.
We swam over here. Although some of my people might have tried to.
With ships.
Uh-huh.
By the way, whereof I spake unto thee,
uh-huh,
thou shalt see it no more again.
So we want to go see our homeland again, which is Jerusalem. We are not from Africa, people. We are not. So we won't see our Jerusalem again until he come and get us out of this situation. Keep reading.
There ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies. That's so crucial. We don't want to say who our enemy is, but who sold us. And who bought us in off the slave ship? The so-called white man. And the Bible said what?
Ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
He calls them our enemies. The so-called white man is our enemy. I didn't make this up. That's not my feelings. That is thus says the Lord.
That's right.
He said when we got off them slave ships, we will be sold into our enemy. Young brother, you got time for us? Come on, man. Our people don't want to know what's going on, man. We got to get ready, man. It's war time. We have to get ready. Keep reading.
There ye shall be sold unto your enemies,
uh-huh,
for bond men and bond women.
Uh-huh.
And no man shall buy you.
And no man is going to ever get us out of this situation that we're in, man. We cannot get saved from no man because man didn't put us in this situation. The Most High put us on the bottom. Even though he gave us the greatest thing, which was the covenant and the law, he still put us on the bottom for breaking the covenant and the law. So he said no man will be able to buy you. No man will get us out of this condition that we're in. We get shot down in these streets, no man gonna save us. We gotta go to work every day working for these white folks, no man will save us. You know what I mean, brother, you don't got time for? Man, brothers ain't like they mad at us, man. We out here for y'all.
That's right.
We ain't did nothing to you, brother, but tried to show you love. Y'all mad at us. And no man shall buy you. No man will be able to save us out of these conditions. They go to Deuteronomy 42 for you. Because we get a lot, we do a lot of things, man. We do a lot of things not according to the Bible. Everything we do it and it's not of God. But yet still, we want to do it. We want to go to church on Sunday. As not to say, we want to eat pork, you can't. So the Most High told us that it's going to be problems if you do add or subtract out this book. Read,
this is Deuteronomy, chapter 4, verse 2.
Read.
And ye shall not add unto the word which I command you.
So all these pastors out here calling us Gentiles, all these Christianities going to church on Sunday, not obeying the Sabbath, the true Sabbath, which is Saturday. All these people doing Thanksgiving, Christmas. How you doing, sister? You doing how you got time for it? Good Father, you know who you are according to the Bible? You do? You sure you do? I don't think we do, sister. I see you in pants and I see you got red hair.
That's, give me Proverbs 31:9. That's exactly why I just pulled this scripture for you. Don't run. Don't run now. Don't run. Give me Proverbs 31:9.
The book of Proverbs chapter 31 and verse 9. Open thy mouth.
Do what?
Open thy mouth.
What else, Doc?
Judge righteously.
Battle axes, do what?
Judge righteously.
Open thy mouth. We're supposed to judge you according to the book and the laws of the Bible. But then y'all want to talk and hit the skates. Y'all want to go skating up down the street. Oh, you ain't supposed to judge. That's a lie. That's what we are doing, breaking down the lies. You are supposed to judge if you follow the laws. You're not supposed to be no hypocrite. I can't judge you if I'm out here doing the same thing you're doing. That's why you got to set yourself apart. You got to let your light shine, man. And let these people know that we are the true judges of the Bible. Who y'all think? Judge Mathis the judge? What's that white lady, so-called white lady name? Judge Judge Judy? Y'all think she the judge? She ain't nothing. She ain't nothing. She ain't no judge. We the real judges of the Bible.
That's right.
Keep reading that Deuteronomy 4 and 2. Because we add away, we add from this book, man.
What was that we took at Revelation 22 and 18?
It's the same. It's saying the same thing. Let me get that too. We're going to precept this thing today.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 2. Ye shall not add unto the word which I command you.
So don't be trying to put your own words or how you want to feel to make yourself be right in this Bible. If the Bible cuts you up, it just cuts you up. You cannot add or subtract from this book.
Neither shall ye diminish up from it.
You got time for us, brother? How you doing, man? We out here for you, big brother. We need you, man. Our leaders definitely have failed us, man. I can't understand how our children act, but our children are really out of line because they didn't get taught by our leaders, by our elder people, man. Our older generation has failed us as well. So we out here to break down these lies, man.
That ye may keep the commandments of the Lord.
Nah, that you should try to keep the commandments of the Lord.
That ye may keep brother. The commandments of the Lord.
Brother, we done dealt with you folks. Give me some time, man. Because I know you got a lot of knowledge, man. You know what I'm saying? But it might not be according to this book. How you been doing? You got your phrases? Where your phrases? You know we talking to you about these phrases.
I'm not in the group.
I know you're not in the group, brother. It don't matter about that. You got to keep these laws, brother. It don't matter about being in a group or not. Now, you're supposed to gather together with your people. But you got to keep these laws, brother. Because you already on the right path to try to get some knowledge. You understand? When I talked to you the other day, last time, you surprised me that you had so much knowledge. You understand? And that's what we can't do. I cannot look at you and think, oh, just because he don't look right, then he ain't got no knowledge. Well, it's not according to the Bible, brother. You know what I'm saying? But we have to work free. I see you wearing your beard, but let it grow. I see you edging it up a little bit. We got to let it grow. You understand what I'm saying? Give me a finish that out for me. You finish that for me too.
Your God, which I command you.
Which he commanded us to do. So that 4:2 is saying that we should not add or subtract from the book. If he said that we got to work fringes, brother, that's what we got to do.
That's right.
If he said not to go to church on Sunday and to do it on Sunday, which is a true Sabbath, that's what we got to do.
That's right.
If he said don't do Christmas, don't do Halloween, don't do Thanksgiving, then that's what we have to do.
That's right.
Not do it. Give me numbers 15 to 38. I'm going to give you these fringes right quick. I still want Isaiah 28 and 9.
I was on my way to
meet
my partner.
You would? Shoot, how you know you're going to make it there? You understand what I'm saying? Like, this is how we got to start thinking, brother. How we know we're going to make it to see our partners? How we know we're going to get on that train to make it to our destination? How we know we gonna ride this scooter and ride it till the wheels fall off of this thing? We don't know that. The Most High can crack this Bible, this sky anytime, man. You know what I am, brother? You know who you are, according to the Bible? Who are you? Who are you according to the Bible? What's your nationality? If I ask you, what race of people did you come from? What nationality of people did you come from?
Jewish.
You came from the Jewish people?
Jacob.
Yeah, we are from the lineage of Jacob, and we are the Jews of the Bible, but you understand,
right.
We right. But a lot of people want to say that we Africans and all this here and there. Go back to Deuteronomy 7, well, finish that, we'll do that. 15 to 38, because you see these right here? These are commandments.
Chapter 15, verse 38.
Bring it out,
speak unto the children of Israel.
Nah, this is for everybody.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
You know, the first thing we got to do, y'all, we got to go identify who Israel is.
Because Israel in his Bible was 2,000 times. Israel, he said, speak to the children of Israel and do what?
And bid them that they make them bridges.
And command them, that word bid means tell them, command them to make them fringes. That's what we all wear on the bottom of my shirt. To stand out. And it's going to show you why.
In the borders of their garments.
So we're supposed to put these fringes on all our shirts and the borders of our garments.
Throughout their generations.
What does throughout your generation mean? Forever. If I have children, if he have children, if he have children, if you have children, if you have children, we have to tell our children, to keep this until Christ come back, man. Till the Most High come back and save us. He said throughout their generations. That's forever, brother. We cannot stop wearing these. And it's going to tell you why.
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
So we're supposed to wear a ribbon of blue. You see everybody got this blue piece? Some kind of blue piece on the bottom? You're supposed to board it with a blue piece on the bottom.
39. And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that ye may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord.
So you see what these fringes are? Therefore, you remember the commandments of the Bible. Y'all doing all right, brother and sister? We out here for y'all, man. We need y'all to come back. For these are remembrance. So you out there doing something, you like, oh, man, I got my fringes on. They remember, man, I'm tripping. Let me get back right, man. Let me keep doing what the Most High told me to do. Appreciate that, brother. Let me get back to these laws, man. That's what the scripture just said. These fringes are nothing more than just to remember. To do the commandments, brother. Remember it. That's what it is. Give me Zephaniah 1 and 8. Keep going. Hey, come back, brother. We need you, man. You heard about the fringes? You think you can get you some fringes, man? I know you could, brother. They're not high at all, man. And then you got people to sew them on for cheap, man. For real, if you really about it, man, come back and we can get you some fringes. We really can. You know what I'm saying? Are we keep raising that?
And to do them.
And to what?
And do them.
And to what?
And to do them.
So these fringes are for to remember the laws, remember the covenant, and to do it. That's the key word, to do it. We have to do these laws, man. We have to keep our fringes on as remembrance to wake us up, man, and stop going back into this wicked world.
That's right.
You understand what I'm saying? Give me Deuteronomy 7:6 again, because I want you to know who you are, young brother. You are a special person, man, to us. The world might not tell you that. You look on the news, the world won't show you that. You see how they do us out here? The world won't show us that we are or who we are, but Deuteronomy 7:6 gonna tell us exactly who we are. Bring that out, brother.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6.
Read.
For thou art an holy people.
For we are a separate people.
Unto the Lord thy God.
Possession. The Lord thy God. We got to stop letting everybody cling on our God. Yeah, that's my God. He doesn't know it ain't. He the God of these 12 tribes.
That's right.
He the God of these 12 tribes, Israel. He keeps saying it in the Bible.
That's right.
He keeps saying it. Finish that out. Give me Amos 3:1. He keeps saying it. He tell you every single time that he is the God of Israel, man, and none else. Everybody want to go into, oh, well, he made everybody. It don't matter. He made everybody for a specific reason.
That's right.
Just like you eat pork. You eat pork. We're not supposed to, brother. People like to say, oh, well, he made the pig. He did. But he made it for what he made it for. He made the pig to be a waster, brother, to eat everything, man, because the pig can eat anything. You can throw your little daughter or pimp out there full of crap, and that pig go eat it. And then guess what? The pig don't sweat. It doesn't have sweat glands. It don't regurgitate the food. So you finna put that bacon on that pan, and it's just finna start sizzling around because it don't sweat. But when we start running, what we do? That's because our body is made that way to take out the bad dioxins in our body. That's what that's for. A lot of people don't know that. But keep reading it.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people.
The Lord thy God chose you, brother. He chose you too, man. You know that? You know you chosen? You know you great, man. You know you're a king, brother? You're a king, big brother, for real, man. But we got to obey the laws, brother. For real, man. This ain't nobody else gonna spend their Sabbath telling you this. We could be out there doing what everybody else doing, but we out here on these streets trying to wake up these two young brothers, man, and more than just two,
But we might won't get two. We might just get one. We might not get none, but we gonna do what the Lord told us to do.
That's right.
And let's come out here on Saturday and wake up our people, man, and come together with our people. So we brought out them fringes. You got this in for now? Hold that, bro. We got the fringes on because you know what these are? These are fringes for us to work to remember to keep the laws. That's right, Yahusha, Yahshua, you know, we all got all our different Yah, that Yah, that Yah, you know what I'm saying? That's who it is, man. And this is why we're supposed to wear the fringes, because it's a remembrance to do the
commandments. It's up for now, chapter 1 and verse 8.
Bring it out.
And it shall come to pass.
It's going to happen.
In the day of the Lord's sacrifice.
What you think the Lord's sacrifice is?
Huh?
Will he come back and destroy this kingdom? Because guess what? He's going to sacrifice a lot of people that he made. That's what people don't understand. He created everything. But yet instead, he gonna come and sacrifice all of them. All that for us. For us.
Uh-huh. That I will punish the princes and the king's children.
And then he gonna punish the women, which are princesses, and the men, which are the kings of this Bible. We are the kings, but we gotta act like young brothers.
And all such as are clothed with strange apparel.
You understand that? Because remember, I asked you if your job will let you wear. You got a job too, don't you? Your job will let you wear anything? You got a certain dress code. You can't wear no beard. And guess what? It's a commandment in the Bible to wear a beard. But them white men, them white folk don't want you to wear that beard. They want you to be out of line. They want you to be out of order so you won't get the blessings. So the Bible said that he will punish the princesses, the women, and the kings say that again.
And I will punish the princes and the king's church and all such as are clothed with strange apparel.
That's strange apparel if you ain't got on no fringes. That's strange apparel for a woman to be walking around in some tights or some pants. That's strange apparel to the king, man. And he said he gonna punish all of them in his day of the Lord's sacrifice. That's the day he come back and give us his kingdom back. When he destroy America. Because y'all don't understand, America's gonna be destroyed, brother. This is New Babylon. America will be destroyed, man, in 1 hour. Guess how it's going to get destroyed? With nuclear fire. Y'all think God is all love, huh?
They say God loves everybody, but they can't be true if he said...
that he got chosen people?
Yeah, then he said he hated Esau.
But give me that. We'll get that right quick. I got about 5 minutes. Give me Romans 9:13. You're right, brother. How can he say that he loved everybody and then he contradicts himself and say he hated a certain group of people? That's not our God, because our God said he's not the author of confusion. He's not going to confuse us. He said he's not going to do that. He's going to give it to us straight. So you think that God loves everybody? Let's see what he say.
The book of Romans chapter 9 and verse 13.
Uh-huh.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
Jacob was our forefather. That's what our lineage is. See, that's what we are dealing with, bloodline. We dealing with bloodline. You come from a great bloodline. You come from a bloodline of priests and kings. Jacob was our forefather. So he said, for Jacob have I loved. Keep reading.
But Esau.
But who?
But Esau.
But who?
But Esau.
But Esau. Y'all know who Esau is? According to the Bible, it's the so-called white man. And you know, we say so-called because this is not a white man. This is a white board. But look across the street. Are those white people? No, they are red.
That's right.
And the Bible describes them as red too. Because as soon as you hit one of them, or as soon as they get pissed or get angry, they turn red. That's what they are. They don't have the pigments in their skin like us. That's why they got to put that sunburn on in their sun. But guess who can be in that sun all day? We can. That's why we got melanin. That's why they stealing our children, man. All these children coming up missing. All these people coming up missing. Nobody got to know where they are. They trying to take the melanin out of these people, man. It's serious, man. So we are trying to break down these lies, brother. What you have for me? You had that red. Come on, we'll get that before we go.
This is Genesis chapter 25, verse 25.
Read.
And the first came out red all over like a hairy garment.
So this was Rebecca. She birthed two nations. This is back in Genesis. Rebecca birthed two nations, two separate manner of people. That's what the Bible said. He said one of them was going to come out red and hairy, like a hairy garment.
That's describing Esau.
And they called his name Esau.
They called his name who?
Esau.
What they call him?
Esau.
Keep reading.
And after that came his brother out, and his hand took hold on Esau. describe him.
Now you hear that? Did they describe his brother? Because they said Esau came out red and hairy, like a hairy garment, right? But then they said after that came his brother, and he took the heel of Esau. That means that we got next to the king. That means as soon as they finished their run, then we got next, and guess what? We got forever. But it didn't describe Jacob. It described Esau, but it didn't describe Jacob. Why? Because he was the same man. All the people in the Bible were so-called black people, man. That's why you ain't got to describe who already is. You understand what I'm saying? Esau came out as a new, as something different. But if Jacob didn't get described, that means Jacob was already who everybody was. So-called black man. That's why this Bible is for us, man. We got to get this Bible and read, man, for real. What you got?
They lead that lead into captivity, so you put in captivity.
Let's go to Revelation 13 and 10.
He's talking about like the kingdom and the kingdom of God, like they're gonna serve.
That's right, because you know what the white man, so-called white man gonna be? He gonna be our slave. Ain't it firm? If we was his slave, shouldn't he be our slave? When the kingdom comes, yeah, they gonna have to fix what they messed up. All this stuff they put into the earth, all this stuff they put into our bodies, this GMOs that we eat and stuff. They gonna have to pay for that, bro. We might not look like it or we might not think it, but the most I said it, and this was going to happen. Read it. This is going to be my last scripture. You're right. You're absolutely right. And this is exactly what it said.
This is Revelation chapter 13, verse 10.
Uh-huh.
He that leadeth into captivity.
Esau, who led us into captivity when we got out these boats in America, the so-called white man,
shall go into captivity.
Esau, the so-called white man who saved us, shall go into captivity. These are not my words. This is thus said the Lord.
He that killeth with the sword.
Esau, the so-called white man that love to kill our people down in these streets, shoot us in our backs, hands up in the air, and they still shoot us, kill us with the sword. What's going to happen to Esau, the so-called white man that kill us with the sword?
Must be killed with the sword.
No, that Bible didn't say he must be killed with the sword.
Must be killed with the sword.
So I'm letting your people know, my people, guess what? We got next, y'all.
That's right.
It's coming.
Right.
It's coming. They did it to us, and guess what? We gonna do it to them.
That's right.
And that's thus said the Lord. That ain't my words. If I'm lying, I'm done. That's the Most High's word.
Right.
Esau, let us and Kentucky into captivity. They gonna go into captivity. And as simple as that, y'all gonna fix what y'all messed up. Y'all gonna fix how y'all did my people, how y'all slaved us, how y'all killed our ancestors, how y'all fed our babies to alligators, how y'all had our grandmas in them cotton fields, how y'all got us in these cotton fields today, working on these jobs 12, 15 hours, while y'all kicking back, relaxing. Be that leaders in captivity shall go into captivity. All praises to the Most High God, and shall bless.
From the door, we won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war. We can't be defeated, let them know from the door. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis.